Hi everyone and welcome back. So here we can understand the proto property of an object and the prototype linking, how that is happening. So here we can understand the proto chaining and prototype chaining. So you can see we are creating the, so consider there is a super type function, super type and subtype. Okay, we are creating the super type object, we are creating the super type object, super type object and subtype object. So how the chaining will happen? The subtype proto will point to the super type proto will point to the super type, and super type proto will point to the object create prototype, and that will again point to null, right? Same thing, if we thought about the same example where we have a super type as a function and subtype as a function. Super type is having super type dot prototype object, right? Which is having get summary name and some constructor property. Same thing, we were having a subtype. Subtype prototype is having get sum age name property and a proto property, right? So whenever we are creating the subtype object, so here we are creating subtype object with the name as a property, right? Because this subtype function is having name as a property. So this proto will link to subtype prototype, and again the subtype prototype proto will link to the super type prototype object, and that will again link to the object prototype, which will further go to null. This is how the chaining is happening. So you had the chaining like subtype object dot age. It will try to find that variable inside a subtype. If it is not there, it's like you are calling get sub age function onto the subtype object, then it will say, okay, I already have get sub age, I can execute it. But if you are calling get super name, then what will happen? It will look up, it will do the lookup in the upper chain. So it will look up into the further prototype, and it found that in the super type dot prototype. We already inherited super type dot prototype already. So if you see, this chaining is happening. So if you are, let's talk about this subtype dot name. So this property is not there on the subtype object, right? It will get it from the super type. So there is already a linking exist. So it will get it from there. Age is a property of subtype. So it will get it from the subtype prototype only. Get super name is a property of a super type. So it will get it from the upper link. Get sub age is a property of subtype object, subtype function only, so it will get it from here. Okay, so here we are inheriting all the properties, and what we are doing here, so when we writing this line, this means that all the properties and method that explicitly exist on the instance of supertype now will also be available on the subtype dot prototypes, because this is inheritance. We are, whatever the prototype properties we are having on the super type, that will all be available onto the subtype. But here we are actually creating the super type instance. So all the properties available on the super type instance is now available on the subtype prototype. And if we are creating the object from the subtype prototype function, then all the objects like subtype object, right? This is created from the subtype function. This will also get the property name, proper method get super name in it. Okay, so this is all about the chaining of what we are calling prototype chaining or proto chaining or whatever you can call. Let's talk about the object chaining also. Like we created object x, then we created object y using object.create, then we are creating object z using object.create y. So xyz, right? So when you try to get some property from Z, you can get it directly, but some property which is not there on Z, it will try to look up onto the upper layer Y prototype, Y proto, and then X proto. We'll talk about that.